Brandon Ayuk's about to be a Pittsburgh Steeler. It's happening. It hasn't happened yet, but I'm just calling it now. Based off everything we've seen over the last couple days, the reports, the rumors, when you line it all up, add it all up, 49ers and Steelers about to agree to a trade. Some point today, tomorrow, who knows when it's going to be. It's going to be soon, though. I think that's the vibes right now. And so much so that you have the main media members backtracking a little bit here. Adam Schefter, Ian Rappaport, and saying that the Steelers are very much still in this. And this is after Adam Schefter himself earlier today. He was on Pat McAfee's show, like in the morning, I guess around noon or whatever, said that the Steelers were out. And then 30 minutes ago just tweeted that the Steelers have re-engaged with talks with the 49ers. Ian Rappaport went on NFL Network today, just 30 minutes ago, an hour ago, said the Steelers are in this. Where did we leave off? The main reports were, all the mainstream media members were saying, it's the Browns and the Patriots. Steelers are out of it. Commanders are out of it. The Browns and Patriots have offers that the 49ers would agree with, and those are the two teams that are in the running right now. What I tell you on the show earlier today, though, I mean, Steelers ain't out of it because Brandon Ayuk still has to want to go to the team that's trading for him, and he doesn't want to go to the Browns. He doesn't want to go to the Patriots, so that helps the Steelers leverage. They're not out of it. They just don't want to give the 49ers whatever they want. So talks are happening again right now, late into this afternoon, and we'll see if a trade gets done. So it looks like those Twitter accounts, those social media accounts that the mainstream was shitting on yesterday were more accurate than what they wanted to give him credit for. The dude with the dog as his profile picture, Ricky, that dude, and the 49ers reporter that has like 50-50 credibility, shaky credibility. Looks like those guys might have been right all along. They called it. They called it before everyone else. They called it at like 3 or 4 o'clock. It was while I was doing the podcast. They called it. They said, Steelers, 49ers, they got an Ayuk deal done. It's just details and semantics going forward now. But that's going to be the deal. Brandon Ayuk's going to be a Pittsburgh Steeler. Then you had everyone on the networks and stuff saying like, yo, listen, there's no deal in place yet. There's no deals getting done soon. A little bit after that, there's some backtracking going on. Okay, 49ers are talking to four teams. Commanders, Steelers, Patriots, Browns. Then late into the night, Steelers and Commanders are apparently out of it because they aren't giving enough to the 49ers. Niners like the trade packages from the Browns and the Patriots. They can agree on that. So those are the main two teams. But again, Ayuk's got to agree to go to his future team as well. So that always left the Steelers in it. So what would the deal be, or what could the deal be? Andrew Filippone gives us some insight. He says, here's what I've heard the Steelers are willing to put into a trade for Brandon Ayuk. Dan Moore, James Daniels, Calvin Austin, or a second-round pick. But he says the 49ers are looking for one of these. A first-round pick, Pat Freiermuth, or George Pickens. Yeah, no wonder the deal isn't done yet. No wonder. We're not giving up a first-round pick, Pat Freiermuth, or George Pickens. Flat out. We're not doing it straight up. Like, it's idiotic. Why the hell would we give up? I could see maybe a first-round pick. You know what? I'll say that. I could see us just giving up a pick because it's not going to hurt us for this year. We're only adding to the team for this year and bringing on a Brandon Ayuk. We did it with Minkah Fitzpatrick back in the day. But I still don't think we're pressed. We didn't have to pay Minkah immediately either. That's the difference between these two situations. We got to pay Brandon Ayuk as soon as he gets here the $25-plus million-a-year contract. Minkah Fitzpatrick, we got to wait and see for a couple years. So, man, first-round picks even probably too steep. But that makes more sense than the players. We're not giving up our best tight end and or George Pickens. Come on. We're not doing that. Like, George Pickens is arguably better than Brandon Ayuk. Let's just put it that way. He's 2 years into this thing. Brandon Ayuk's been around longer, and Pickens is putting up Pro Bowl type numbers already with Mason Rudolph, Kenny Pickett, and Mitch Trubisky last year, and Matt Canada as his offensive coordinator for the majority of the season. Like, come on, why would we give up George Pickens for Brandon Ayuk? Let's just say it's a wash right there. Let's just say they're a wash. How about that? And then have to turn around and pay Brandon Ayuk $25-plus million a year, where we still have George Pickens under contract for the next two seasons on his rookie deal. Make it make sense. Please, someone tell me, make it make sense. And then if we trade Pat Freiermuth, who's our number one tight end? It's just stupid. Absolutely stupid. That's why the deal isn't done. If this is true, that's exactly why the deal isn't done. Omar Khan isn't giving up any of that shit. So if it's a second-round pick and a player, like second-round pick and a Calvin Austin, okay, makes a little bit more sense. And if Brandon Ayuk's going to take a discount to come to Pittsburgh, you know, $25 million per year, $26 million per year, that makes more sense. I prefer it being a third-round pick and one of these players, Calvin Austin, James Daniel, Dan Moore. But if it's a second-round pick, you get Brandon Ayuk, watch out, man. Watch out for this offense. Like, you can't tell me the downside of it for this season. You cannot. You could talk maybe long-term ramifications, not having that second-round pick. How does Ayuk and his contract age out? You could talk about that, but for this season, you can't really mention a downside. Outside of Ayuk potentially messing up the chemistry, just seeing how he vibes with the team, how he potentially reacts to not getting as many targets as he had with the 49ers. How does he look in this system? But with us having a competent offensive coordinator, with us having a Russ, a Fields, this upgraded O-line, Ayuk's going to have Pickens across from him. It's not going to be just Ayuk here where he's getting doubled at all. I think things will work out just fine. And there's not going to be much controversy at all or chemistry issues, anything like that. But let me know your thoughts with these updated reports. Updated news. I think it's just going to be a matter of time. So stay tuned because this is ongoing. I think Brandon Ayuk's going to be a Steeler. I guess the only question now is what number does he get? Van Jefferson's 11. What number is Brandon Ayuk going to get? But stay chilling. Hope you enjoyed. Peace.